Hello and welcome back. In this session, I'll be teaching you how to delete a transaction that has been made by a mistake. Now, the best practice is to make a reverse entry. So for example, if you've applied a charge, you could raise a credit note to reverse that charge. That's where you see an audit trail of what's happened. If you can imagine, for example, if your bank has made a mistake, they're not going to just delete the transaction, they will make a reverse entry so you can see the trail of what's gone on. So into account, let's go to transaction history and then easily locate transactions by using the search filters at the top. Now to delete a transaction, just simply tick the box and click on delete down the bottom. Let's click expand all to open up the transactions and see what they're composed of. It's pretty clear from this page that ticking a box will delete the entire group of transactions that you see here. But rents work in a slightly different way. The rent due record that you see here will be linked to the rent once it's received, and deleting one transaction will delete its accompanying group of transactions. So let me show you this in practice. Let's go to collect the rent and then take a payment. Now that the payment has been received, let's go back to transaction history. As you can see, the two transactions that we see here, rent due and rent received, are now linked. You can now consider this as one group of transactions, even though the rent charge and the rent received may be on different dates. So we may not be looking at them side by side like we are now. Now we'll only select one transaction, which is the one that we see down at the bottom, the rent due. And once we process the transaction, you'll see that it's also going to delete its related transaction above. And there you go, both transactions have now been deleted.